You know what I find interesting? Well, if you've been a follower of this channel, I think you know it by now. Short-lived states. There are well-known examples, there are lesser-known examples, there are unknown examples, non-existing examples, and there was the Alsace-Lorraine Soviet Republic. Ever heard of that? Exactly. That's what we're going to talk about today. Good to have you back on the channel if you're new. I'm Stefan, I'm a Dutch history teacher. I like to cover history on location for you. And if you like it, consider subscribing and also hit that notification bell. To understand how this short-lived state came to be, we need to go back to 1870. Because then the Franco-Prussian War broke out. And in the following year, the Germans proclaimed victory and they annexed the Alsace-Lorraine region from France. From now on, this region, and also its cities such as Colmar, Mulhouse and Strasbourg, they were now part of the German Empire. The territory encompassed all of Alsace and over a quarter of Lorraine. The region was never fully integrated into the German Empire. There were issues about religion, economics, politics, since the region was directly governed by Berlin and had barely any autonomy, although there was the 1911 Constitution. A year before the outbreak of World War I, in 1913, there was the Zaven affair, which I explained in the previous video. Please check that one out in the top right corner if you haven't already. And then, in 1914, the First World War broke out. The French tried to advance into the area. Just as we saw elsewhere on the Western Front of the First World War, the fighting resulted into a stalemate, and there were 30,000 military deaths in this region. It was nicknamed Little Verdun. What happened to the citizens of the region in terms of military draft? From the 350,000 recruits, around 17,000 deserted to join the French army. Thousands more fled to neutral Switzerland. German high command feared problems when stationing Alsace refugees on the Western Front. Therefore, many of them were sent to the Eastern Front or served in the Navy or logistics behind the front line. Flash forward to 1918, September. When Bulgaria left the war, the German Kaiser Wilhelm II had a meeting with his generals, General Hindenburg and Ludendorff. Ludendorff argued the war was lost. He argued that left-wing politicians were to blame, not the army command. Basically, the stab-in-the-back myth was born here. Also, a process of democratization was set in motion. This was done to subdue revolutionary sentiments, and also it might give a democratic Germany a better position at the negotiation table with the American President Woodrow Wilson, who had presented his 14 points plan. Wilson wanted to negotiate with a Germany that was represented by the German people and not by a despotic Kaiser or army command. Wilson rejected this offer since he did not believe Germany was now represented by the people, but still by despots. The German high command now cried for a fighting till the last man, but it never came to that. At the end of October, Germany had transformed into a parliamentary democracy with Bavarian Prince Maximilian von Baden as Reich Chancellor. Von Baden was supported by a large degree of political parties, also by Wilhelm II. Ludendorff was fired. Hindenburg could remain, because his resignation would lead to a moral collapse of the army. Yet Hindenburg was sidetracked to make way for new first quartermaster Wilhelm Gruner. Yet, a revolution still occurred. In the wake of the revolution, the Alsace-Lorraine Soviet Republic was born. It started in Kiel, where a mutiny broke out on November 3rd, which was led by socialists and communists. Soon, uprisings at other naval cities like Bremen, Lübeck, Hamburg and Tilsit occurred. On the 7th, the revolution spread inland. The German government resigned and a new social democrat government with Friedrich Ebert as Reichschancellor was appointed. This happened on November 9th. On the same day, the German government declared a republic. The German Kaiser went into exile to the Netherlands.
On the 10th of November 1918, the Alsace-Lorraine Soviet Republic was proclaimed. But how did this happen? Well, Marxist councils of soldiers and workers were set up. And not only here in Strasbourg, also in Colmar and Mulhouse.
These were imitations of Russian Soviets. This happened because of a power vacuum. See, German annexed Alsace-Lorraine was under direct control of the Kaiser, but the Kaiser had abdicated. It was the Soviet of Strasbourg that claimed the foundation of the Republic of Alsace-Lorraine. This was done by Alsatian soldiers who were already against German control of their territory and now saw the chance to revolt, and they moved into the region. The revolution spread to other cities too. In Strasbourg, red flags appeared in the city, an amnesty was declared, and freedom of press was proclaimed. Factory workers went on strike, demanding higher wages. The Soviets, councils, raised wages by decree against the opposition of the factory owners. The Social Democratic Party leader in Strasbourg, Jacques Peyrotte, wanted none of this, and since it was more than likely that the region would soon be incorporated by the French, he requested French generals to send in troops to restore order.
11 days later, the French soldiers moved in, and strikes occurred but were ended by force and agitators arrested. The French now took control of the area of Alsace-Lorraine. And so the very short-lived Alsace-Lorraine Soviet Republic was no more. It had barely existed 2 weeks. Because Alsace-Lorraine was incorporated into France, it didn't see the post-war violence that we saw throughout the former German Empire after the First World War. However, troubles returned because in May 1940, Germany attacked France once again and proclaimed victory after a short but vicious campaign. And Alsace-Lorraine was re-annexed into the German Reich. But that is a story for another time. Now, if you like to learn about other shortlist states, you can click right here. I want to thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe. And au revoir from Strasbourg in France.